proclamation by the Governor General, Cecil LaGrenard. Reads, whereas by proclamation dated the 3rd day of October 2017, issued under subsection 1 of section 52 of the Constitution of Grenada, Parliament was prorogued on the 6th day of October 2017. And whereas it is provided by subsection 1 of section 51 of the Constitution of Grenada, that each session of Parliament shall be held at such place within Grenada and shall commence at such time as the Governor General may by proclamation appoint. And whereas it is further provided by subsection 2 of section 51 of the Constitution of Grenada, that there shall be a session of Parliament once at least in every year, so that a period of 6 months shall not intervene between the last sitting of Parliament in one session and the first sitting of in the next session. Now therefore, I, Cecile LaGrenard, Dame Grand Cross of the Most Distinguished Order of St. Michael and St. George, Officer of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, Governor General in and over Grenada, do hereby appoint the Trade Center at Montrouge in the parish of St. George as the place where the 6th session of the 9th Parliament shall be held at 10 o'clock in the forenoon on Friday, 20th day of October 2017, as the time at which the said session shall begin. And members of the said Parliament and all other of Her Majesty's officers and loving subjects in Grenada and all others whom it may concern are hereby required to take due notice hereof and give their ready obedience accordingly, given under my hand and the public seal of Grenada, this 10th day of October 2017, in the 65th year of the reign of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. God save the Queen.
Let us pray. Guide, we beseech thee, Almighty God, members of both houses, that they may wisely deliberate for the good of the country and for the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Let us all join together and say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Honorable members, that the houses do now adjourn during pleasure to await the arrival of Her Excellency the Governor General. If so, please say yea. Pray be seated.
This house now stands adjourned to await Her Excellency the Governor General.
Mr. President, Mr. Deputy Speaker, Members of Parliament, our nation embarks on this sixth session of the Ninth Parliament with a deep sense of gratitude to Almighty God for his countless blessings on our beautiful Tri-Island state. We are indeed grateful for all that we have collectively achieved in the past year and look forward to the future with optimism and renewed confidence in our collective capacities to advance our country's development. Mr. President, Mr. Deputy Speaker, Grenada is a country of caring people from coast to coast and from village to village. The immense kindness of our people was clearly demonstrated in our quick and generous response to our regional sisters and brothers in the islands devastated by Hurricanes Irma and Maria. My government expresses its profound gratitude to all persons in our Tri-Island state who have contributed in any way, large or small, to the emergency relief and recovery efforts in the affected islands. My government urges all Grenadians to continue to show compassion, solidarity, and generosity. The times in which we live demand nothing less. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government fully recommits itself to the principles of democracy, social justice, and the rule of law. A significant symbol of our democracy is our Parliament building. Therefore, it is with pleasure that my government notes that construction of our new Parliament building is on track to be completed by the end of this year. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, consistent with the terms of safeguarding our gains, securing a brighter future, the overarching focus of my government for this session of Parliament will be the economy, society, and the environment. Accordingly, the key priorities of my government are as follows. 1, maintaining economic prudence and fiscal discipline, implementing structural reforms to enhance competitiveness, expand economic opportunities, increase employment, and build resilience to both economic and environmental shocks. 3, pursuing strategic investments to advance our socio-economic development in a manner that is people-centered and compatible with environmental sustainability. Maintaining economic prudence and fiscal discipline. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government is committed to safeguarding our hard-won gains by maintaining economic prudence and fiscal discipline. In May of this year, my government successfully completed its homegrown structural adjustment program, which was supported by the International Monetary Fund and other development partners. The many structural, fiscal, and institutional reforms that were implemented during the 3-year period of the adjustment program have yielded remarkable results. Our economic situation has improved dramatically since 2013, and our country now has an economic success story of which all Grenadians should be proud. The positive economic achievements are the result of the shared sacrifice, collective resolve, and commitment of our people. It gives my government great pleasure to report that so far for 2017, the economy is on track to register its 5th consecutive year of robust growth. Additionally, public finances have improved, public debt has been reduced significantly, and our country is on a sustainable medium-term growth path. Our country's flagship social protection program has been strengthened, and the unemployment rate is steadily declining. In August of this year, the Fiscal Responsibility Oversight Committee was officially launched with a mandate to monitor and report on my government's compliance with the fiscal rules and targets that are stipulated in the Fiscal Responsibility Law. The committee is a model of good fiscal governance. It is noteworthy that Grenada is the first country in the English-speaking Caribbean to have a legislated Fiscal Responsibility Oversight Committee. Indeed, from a fiscal standpoint, a paradigm shift has occurred in Grenada with the emergence of a new culture of fiscal responsibility and accountability. My government is better managing its public finances. It is carefully weighing the implications of its fiscal actions and is adhering to the fiscal rules and strengthening the monitoring of fiscal risks as required by the Fiscal Responsibility Law. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government is committed to staying the course of economic prudence and fiscal discipline. It will do so by improving tax compliance, enhancing revenue administration and collection, being judicious in how revenue is spent, borrowing only on concessional terms, and exercising overall sound economic stewardship. Our country has clearly emerged from a period of economic distress, and we are forging ahead resolutely, determined to avoid a return to economic darkness. Boosting competitiveness, opportunities, jobs, and economic resilience. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government is committed not only to accelerating economic growth, but also to making this growth more broad-based and inclusive, with increased jobs and opportunities. Accordingly, ongoing efforts to address the constraints to economic competitiveness and productivity will be intensified. My government notes with pleasure the launch in July of this year of the new National Export Strategy for the period 2017 to 2021. This strategy was developed with the assistance of local stakeholders and funding from the Commonwealth Secretariat. It is a comprehensive strategy that sets forth an action plan for export development and, by extension, for economic growth. The following six sectors have been prioritized for export development. One, agriculture and fisheries. Two, the creative industries. Three, health and wellness. Four, marine and yachting services. Five, professional services and tourism. With respect to agriculture, my government will be pursuing strategic investments in the sector with the explicit objectives of improving agricultural productivity, enhancing food and nutrition security, boosting employment and income in rural communities, increasing foreign exchange earnings, and promoting climate-smart agricultural practices. Therefore, the following will be the priorities in 2018. One, supporting youth in agriculture. Implementing the National Land Bank Project. Three, developing and operationalizing a climate-smart agriculture policy. Four, operationalizing the poultry policy and action plan, as well as the livestock policy. And fifth, continuing with the implementation of the Prairie Lastly strategy and action plan, as well as the action plan to address the citrus greening disease. And sixth, strengthening institutional, legislative, and regulatory frameworks. In the area of tourism, my government will continue to enhance the Pure Grenada brand, intensify the marketing of our beautiful destination, commercialize specific sites, and overall improve the tourism product. Moreover, additional room stock will come on stream in 2018 with the expected opening of the Silver Sands Hotel and other real estate projects. My government will continue its ongoing efforts aimed at maintaining, over the long term, a business-friendly environment, promoting strategic and transformative foreign and local investments, supporting the continued enhancement of value-added local products and exports, and broadening access to finance, particularly for small businesses and young entrepreneurs. My government will also continue to focus on expanding economic opportunities by unlocking the potential of new and emerging economic sectors and industries such as the blue and green economies, as well as the creative and cultural industry, which is now being referred to as the orange economy. This year, Grenada saw the start of the first ever offshore drilling campaign to explore for petroleum and natural gas deposits, undertaken by the Global Petroleum Group Limited. The results obtained thus far, which are subject to further analysis and evaluation, have been very encouraging. The exploration should be viewed within my government's broader strategic objective of promoting economic diversification and structural transformation, consistent with the overarching tenets of the forthcoming National Sustainable Development Plan 2030. Expanding economic opportunities is ultimately geared towards creating sustainable employment. My government remains steadfast in its commitment to addressing the country's unemployment challenge, and in particular, to increasing women's participation in the labor force. Therefore, reforming the education and training curriculum to better address the long-term strategic development objectives of my government, as well as the more immediate need of the private sector, is of paramount importance if the unemployment rate is to be lowered more rapidly. Youth unemployment is particularly high, and my government remains resolute in confronting this challenge. This year, for the first time, as part of the annual budget engagement with stakeholders, a consultation was held specifically with the youth. Close to 100 young people participated in a three-hour session on September the 21st, in which they expressed their views on various issues affecting them, unemployment being one such issue. They proposed several solutions to increase youth employment, some of which are being reviewed for inclusion in the 2018 budget. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, building economic resilience is another important policy objective of my government. Therefore, economic and fiscal policies will be deployed in a manner that supports macroeconomic stability. Where surpluses are generated, some will be saved for rainy days to help build fiscal buffers to better cushion the effects of economic downturns should it become necessary to do so. My government has also taken important measures to improve the governance arrangement of state-owned enterprises and statutory bodies in an effort to better monitor and manage fiscal risks. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, the Fiscal Responsibility Law makes provision for a contingency fund to be established from a portion of the inflows generated from our Citizenship by Investment program. As stipulated in the law, the fund is to be used for general budget financing purposes, including contingency spending, natural disasters, and debt reduction. My government is committed to implementing the contingency fund as another means towards strengthening our economic resilience. Strategic and people-centered investments. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government will continue to make strategic and targeted investments to enhance Grenada's human capital as well as upgrade its social and economic infrastructure. In the area of health, my government fully supports the healthcare system through institutional strengthening, capacity building and training, and infrastructure development to improve service delivery. Work continues towards the implementation of the National Health Insurance. A draft preliminary actuarial review of the proposed National Health Insurance Plan has been recently completed and is under consideration by my government. My government is also committed to ensuring that the health infrastructure is adequate to allow the sector to adapt to climate change. In that regard, work has commenced on the retrofit of the Princess Alice Hospital with funding from the Department of International Development. Additional upgrades for the health facilities in Carriacou are also planned. The second phase of construction of the General Hospital is nearing completion and is expected to be commissioned in early 2018. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, with respect to education, the overriding objective of my government is to reduce human resource deficits by promoting a society whose members are educated, informed, and engaged. This objective is to be met through training, skills development, and curriculum redesign, with emphasis being placed not only on science, technology, English, and math, but also on vocational training and civics. Therefore, my government will continue to invest heavily in the improvement of educational outcomes. For 2018, the priorities are improving literacy and numeracy. The ministry will step up efforts to address the persistently lackluster performance in mathematics and English across our schools. 2, strengthening human resource development. The ministry will seek to provide greater access to strategic educational opportunities in a more equitable and transparent manner. 3, upgrading school infrastructure. Several schools are targeted to receive major renovation and rehabilitation work in 2018. The aim of which is to enhance the quality of educational opportunities for our students. 4, building capacity of schools professionals. Emphasis will be placed on the training of principals, teachers, and ministry staff to help improve overall outcomes of the education sector. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government will continue to invest in strengthening social protection and social safety nets to protect the poor and most vulnerable groups in society, such as children, the elderly, and the disabled. My government is also committed to supporting reforms to mainstream gender equality and social inclusion in order to help improve access to basic services. In this regard, priority will continue to be given to meeting the high demands for low-cost housing throughout the country. The second phase of the Chinese low-income housing program is about to commence following the signing of the agreement with the government of the People's Republic of China. This phase of the project is expected to provide homes for 647 families and will be constructed in Bouchajour in St. George's, Corinth, St. David's, Diamond in St. Mark, The Villa in St. Patrick's, and Dumfries in Carriacou. Moreover, My government will seek to further enhance the efficiency of its social expenditure. Reforms of the flagship social assistance program, Support for Education, Empowerment, and Development, or SEED, have been completed. A proxy means testing tool is being used, which allows for the inclusion of new households that are assessed as being poor and vulnerable, and therefore most in need of SEED support. In 2018, all efforts will be made to streamline the payment mechanics of SEED beneficiaries. This will include direct payment into accounts held by beneficiaries at commercial banks and credit unions where possible. My government continues to focus on youth at risk with a view to building Grenada's social capital and promoting safer communities. Only recently, the Awakening Special Potential by investing in restoration and empowerment of youth, Aspire project was launched. The objective of the CDB-funded project is to support the establishment of an improved gender-responsive juvenile justice prevention and response system. The aim is to prevent young people from breaking the law and to rehabilitate young offenders through effective education and psychosocial services. In 2018, my government will implement the Empower program, which is a training program for young men. Additionally, the Actively Committed and Empowered program, ACE, will also be implemented. The objective of the ACE program is to provide training for 25 at-risk youth between the ages of 21 and 30 in the community of Mount Horn. Other important youth empowerment programs, such as the New Imani program, the Hope Pilot program, and the Fostering Level-Headed Youth, or FLY program, will also continue. In the area of sports, my government will continue its work related to refurbishing and lighting of facilities, developing programs in schools and communities, and building capacity of supporting staff, among other initiatives. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government will continue to invest in modern climate and disaster resilient social and economic infrastructure. Under the recently approved World Bank's International Development Association allocation, an amount of East Caribbean dollar, $181 million, was approved for Grenada. 50% of this amount is earmarked to support transformative and strategic investment projects, and the remaining half will go towards policy-based loans to support institutional reforms. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government is committed to investing in soft infrastructure, in particular systems, processes, and institutional arrangements to better serve our people. My government recognizes that a modern, efficient, effective, and productive public service is integral to our country's social and economic progress. Therefore, it is with pleasure that my government notes that the Public Service Management Reform Strategy 2017 to 2019 is carded for further advancement in 2018. The strategy rests on four pillars, namely, one, public service re-engineering to make the government machinery more effective and efficient, two, strategic human resource management to ensure optimal deployment and utilization of human resources. Three, strategic compensation management that is consistent with fiscal sustainability. And four, integrated information and communication technology to enhance service delivery and to create efficiencies in various government operations. My government is also committed to adopting a holistic approach to public administration to enhance policy development, program and knowledge management, and service delivery. New emphasis will be placed on building resilience of the public sector management systems to natural hazards. Support from the World Bank is being sought in this regard. In 2018, the Ministry of Legal Affairs will focus on concluding outstanding matters in the fulfillment of government's legislative agenda in 2018. High on the agenda will be the Pensions Reform Bill and the National Health Insurance Bill. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, on the issue of pension, my government continues to work with a sense of purpose to resolve the matter once and for all. A pension secretariat has been established, and a database of the records of all former and current public workers who are eligible for pension has been developed. Cost estimates and the mechanics for payments are being analyzed. The resolution of the pension issue is a complex public policy matter that requires a great deal of collaborative efforts. However, my government, in spite of the enormity of the task, is steadfast in its commitment to settle the issue of pension. My government wishes to thank all public workers, past and present, as well as the trade unions for their patience, as this mammoth undertaking is being worked out in the best interest of all involved and the country as a whole. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government will continue to invest in strengthening national security to further increase the safety and security of our citizens and visitors alike. Accordingly, my government will continue to support the work of the Royal Grenada Police Force. The force is committed to developing stronger and more constructive relationships with stakeholders at the national and regional levels. In 2018, priority will be given to capacity building and training, as well as infrastructure development, so that officers are better able to combat criminal activities in all of their various forms. Furthermore, Her Majesty's prisons will continue to carry out their mandate of security and rehabilitation, thus contributing to the safe environment in which we live. My government is fully aware that national security is a precondition for Grenada's socio-economic development, in as much as socio-economic development is a necessary condition for national security. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, in relation to foreign affairs, my government will continue to leverage strategic partnerships and relationships for the benefit of our people. Relevant ministries are presently involved in negotiations at the World Trade Organization and at the CARICOM and OECS levels to deepen regional integration, as well as bilateral relations with Cuba and the Dominican Republic. Over the next year, my government will conduct consultations at the national level to ensure that Grenada's interests are reflected in those negotiations and that the agreements contribute to the benefit of our exporters, service providers, and the people of our country as a whole. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, my government is committed to promoting and entrenching good governance. It is therefore noteworthy that the Integrity Commission's second round of declarations continues pursuant to Section 28(2) of the Integrity in Public Life Act No. 24 of 2013. The Commission is also forging ahead with the implementation of the asset declaration system with a view to raising the standard of governance in our country. Environmental security and sustainability. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, the recent monster hurricanes, Irma and Maria, which ravaged many of our Caribbean nations, have brought into sharp focus the issue of climate change. There can be no denying that climate change is real and that it poses a potential existential threat to our humanity. It is therefore urgent and imperative that we strengthen our capacity as a country to adapt and mitigate its effects. We have no choice but to pursue climate-smart development and, in so doing, synchronize economic development with environmental sustainability. The two are inextricably linked. Protecting the environment while simultaneously expanding our economy are not incompatible goals. Indeed, our economic survival and our survival in general demand that we do both. My government is taking active measures to reduce our vulnerabilities and is seeking to support the support of the World Bank in this regard. A team from the bank was in Grenada during the last week of September on an appraisal mission for a proposed development policy loan that will support institutional and other reforms to promote environmental sustainability and build resilience to economic shocks. Policy reforms will focus on climate adaptation and mitigation, protection of natural resources, hazard risk mitigation, disaster risk reduction, protection of coastal and marine ecosystems, and proper physical planning. In addition to the proposed World Bank intervention, my government is pushing ahead with its agenda to enhance energy security and efficiency, diversify Grenada's energy mix, promote the use of renewable energy, and entrench a culture of energy conservation. Among the specific priorities for 2018 will be the implementation of the Blue Growth Master Plan, as well as the Blue Innovation Institute. Furthermore, climate screening of all public investment projects will be institutionalized. Raising environmental awareness in our society will also be given special priority. Indeed, the future development of our country depends on an environmentally conscious citizenry. My government notes with pleasure that NADMA has secured grant funding to implement 5 new projects across the Tri-Island State in 2018, including the construction of 2 new headquarter buildings with storage facilities, one on mainland Grenada and the other on Carriacou. The projects are aimed at further building response and resilience and reducing our vulnerabilities to natural disaster. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, investment in infrastructure is critical in order to support socio-economic development and to incentivize private sector growth. In this regard, the Ministry of Works will continue to undertake a comprehensive and cross-sectoral work program aimed at safeguarding and improving the nation's infrastructure. An integral consideration for all projects is building resilience in order to mitigate the adverse effects of climate change and reduce the vulnerability of the nation's infrastructure. To this end, the ongoing execution of the ministry's asphalt and concrete road maintenance program remains a key priority. Improving the nation's road network is an essential component of economic development. In this regard, the continuation of the agricultural feeder roads with a third phase, which extends the network of roads throughout the interior of the agricultural belt, is a critical benchmark in advancing this mandate. Other major road projects due to commence in 2018 include the St. Patrick's Road Network upgrade and the Guelph Extreme Rainfall Project, both of which will improve primary and secondary routes. The ministry will continue to aggressively procure the technical consultancies required to prepare for the design and supervision of the landmark United Kingdom Caribbean Infrastructure Fund Western Corridor Main Road project, for which construction work is proposed to commence in the last quarter of 2018. Additionally, work is carded to begin on the St. John's River Flood Mitigation Project, which is part of the World Bank-funded Disaster Vulnerability Reduction Project and will target flood mitigation in the River Road area. Other major infrastructural projects scheduled for 2018 include the lighting of the National Cricket Stadium and the Lassajas Playing Field, as well as the installation of flood lighting in community playing fields and basketball courts throughout the island. My government, in partnership with the People's Republic of China, will critically expedite the rehabilitation of the Morris Bishop International Airport to meet operational standards with respect to infrastructure, security, and services, and the provision of adequate accommodation and holding facilities for goods exported and imported. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, Grenada will continue to upgrade its infrastructure to meet the demands of climate change. Through our Honorable Prime Minister, who is the current chair of the Small States Forum, my government will continue to make the case to the international community for concessional financing to fund climate adaptation and mitigation and to meet environmental sustainability objectives more broadly. My government will continue to impress upon the international community the importance of considering vulnerability in any measure of economic development for small island states. The fact is, there can be no true development of the Caribbean small island states if they remain as vulnerable as they are to weather-related shocks. My government urges the international community to recognize the Caribbean's unique situation in this regard and fashion development support and solutions that appropriately relate to our realities. These are not ordinary times, and as such, ordinary solutions and support will not suffice. Conclusion. Mr. President, Mr. Speaker, my government has set out its major priorities for this sixth session of the Ninth Parliament, which are maintaining economic prudence and fiscal discipline, implementing structural reforms to enhance competitiveness, expand economic opportunities, increase employment, and build resilience to both economic and environmental shocks, and pursuing strategic investments to advance our socio-economic development in a manner that is people-centered and compatible with environmental sustainability. My government will elaborate on the details of these when it presents the 2018 budget. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, as we move forward as a nation, the prevailing spirit of patriotism, solidarity, and unity must continue. My government remains committed to the social partnership with the churches, trade unions, the business community, the non-governmental organization, and civil society. My government views this partnership as pivotal to advancing our country's development. Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, members of Parliament, may God guide you all in your deliberations and render you equal to the sacred trust bestowed upon you. May God continue to richly bless our tri-island state and enfold us all in his boundless love and care.
Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, I stand to move the following motion. My name, be it resolved that the Honorable Houses of Parliament record their thanks for the gracious address delivered today by the Governor General, and be it further resolved that debate on the address be deferred to a date to be named.
Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, I beg to second the motion moved by the Prime Minister.
Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, the Senate would like to associate itself with the motion just moved by the Prime Minister.
Mr. Deputy President, Mr. Speaker, I beg to second the motion.
Members of the Senate, is it your wish that the Senate adjourns sine die? All those in favor, say aye. Those against, say no. The ayes have it. Indeed, the ayes have it. The Senate now stands adjourned. Sine die.
Honorable members of the House of Representatives, the debate on the gracious address delivered by the Governor General be deferred to a later date. Those of that opinion say aye. Of the contrary opinion say nay. I think the ayes have it. The ayes have it. Honorable members, members of the House of Representatives, the question is that this Honorable House now stands adjourned. Those of that opinion say aye. Of the contrary opinion say nay. I think the ayes have it. The ayes have it. This Honorable House now stands adjourned.